welcome back to my channel. So today we have a fun and exciting video. Well, to me at least, it's so fun and exciting because it has been highly, highly requested. We're doing my fragrance collection. Yay! I have been into fragrances for a while. It started this year. Like, I just really got into it and I'm just like, oh my gosh, let me smell everything and all the pretty bottles. I just love it. So I did a haul like a few months ago, maybe like earlier this year, and a lot of you have been wanting to see a collection. So here I am. I will do one for you guys and I really hope that you guys like it. But before we get into that, I do have a little haul. FragranceNet.com is actually sponsoring this video. I'm so excited, you guys. I love them. I've worked with them in the past and they have sent over some perfume for me to add to my collection, and also they are hooking it up with a giveaway, you guys. So one of you guys get to win one of the perfumes I'm gonna be sharing with you. So I'm just really excited. But before we get started, I wanted to do a little disclaimer. I am not an expert, you guys. I am like one of the worst people to explain scents. That's kind of why I've been putting this video off for a while. But you guys really wanted to see my collection, so I'm gonna try my best to describe each scent. I'm probably not gonna go into too much detail because I don't want this video to be super long, but I will try and explain the new fragrances that I got. So yeah, anyways, let's go ahead and get started. First item here is my Jo Malone Peony and Blush Suede Cologne. I actually have here the smaller size, which is great for traveling. This is 1 fluid ounce. I actually have the full size, and if you know me, you know this is my favorite perfume. If you're wondering, by the way, this is what the full size looks like. So here's a comparison. And look, my full size is almost gone. You guys, I got this perfume in March and I'm that close to finishing. I just love it. It's my all-time favorite perfume ever. Just like the name, Peony and Blush Suede, you will smell that peony in it. And also, it has a little bit of like an apple scent. It's just to kind of make it a little bit sweeter, and that suede just kind of like balances it out and not make it too florally and too overwhelming. So I just love this perfume. It smells so good and the scent lingers all day long. It doesn't really change to me. I love it. So definitely check this out. I highly recommend it. All right, next perfume is the My Burberry Blush. This is my very first Burberry perfume in my collection, and I actually purchased the like little tiny gift set for this because I wanted to see if I like it first, and I love it so much that I was like, I have to have the full size. So I got it and I'm so excited about it. It smells so good and the packaging is just so freaking adorable. It kind of reminds me of Chloe in a way, but I think it's a little cuter. I don't know. I love this top on it and the gold and the little bow. It's just so cute. So if you're wondering, the key notes on this is pomegranate, rose, and jasmine. And again, this is kind of a florally scent. This one is a little sweeter than the Peony and Blush Suede from Jo Malone. I actually really like this one. It's like very fresh but florally at the same time. It's definitely a girly perfume, but it's not overwhelming, which I like. It doesn't give me a headache. So I love this. It is a new favorite. I'm so happy to add it to my collection. Next, I have the Gucci Bloom perfume. So the bottle on this is really pretty, I think. It's like so simple but so chic at the same time. Now, I actually haven't used this one yet. I had a sampler of this one and I remembered I really, really liked it. So I decided to pick this one up. But yeah, I haven't used this yet. I'm really excited to though. It is also another florally scent, just like the name Bloom. I'm gonna go ahead and read off the keynotes because again, I haven't used this one yet to actually know what it smells like and things like that. So the keynotes on this is Rangoon Creeper, Jasmine Bud, and Tuberose. So this one, you know what? It smells like Sampaguita. If you're Filipino, you know what I'm talking about. It smells like Sampaguita. It's like florally and powdery at the same time. It's actually pretty strong. I really like it though. It smells really good. I'm excited to try this out and wear it and and see how it wears. But so far, I like that. I love that sempagita smells. It's just like florally and powdery. To me, that smells beautiful. All right, last but not the least is this one from Versace. It is Eros Pour Femme. I'm so sorry if I totally butchered that, but the bottle on this is just stunning, you guys. Oh my goodness. So this one has a ton of things in it. So it has a Sicilian lemon, Calabrian bergamot, pomegranate, lemon flower, Sambac jasmine absolute, jasmine infusion, peony, sandalwood, ambrox, musk, and sensual wood. So this one smells florally, but clean, if that makes sense. Like, it smells really good, like kind of not too girly, but just like florally and clean, if that makes sense. It smells really, really good. So I'm very excited to try this out and see how long this wears. After reading some reviews, I saw that a lot of people are saying this scent lingers on for forever. So that's really amazing to me. So I'm very excited to have this in my collection. So for the giveaway, I'm actually giving this perfume right here. Of course, you'll get a new one, but this, you will get the Versace perfume. I will have all the details and rules on how to enter in the description box down below, so definitely check it out. Alright guys, so that is it for my haul. Now let's go into my fragrance collection. Welcome to my collection. So I keep all of my perfumes on top of this chest or drawer, makeup drawers that I have in my room. And yeah, I just love having them on display like this. I love being able to see them because, you know, I want to use them as much as I can. So yeah, and I love the pretty bottles, so this is how I store them. And now let's go ahead and get started. I'll start off with these guys here. These three perfumes are actually from Benefit Cosmetics. I purchased them a few years ago, like back in college, so maybe 3-5 years ago. I do really like them. I have kept them because I don't think they sell perfumes anymore, which is kind of sad because these I absolutely love. So we have here Sasha, and this one is actually a very sexy and like seductive, so I definitely recommend this one for like nighttime. And then we have here Eva, which is super, super fresh. It's actually kind of reminds me of one of the Bath & Body Works candles, kind of like a balsamy type of scent. And then this one right here is very nice and florally and like clean. It's definitely my favorite. It is Lily. So yeah, I have three of those from Benefit Cosmetics. And then we have here the Jo Malone Peony & Blush Suede that I just did a haul on, the Versace as well, the Gucci Bloom, and of course the My Burberry Blush. So we're gonna skip those four. Next we have here the Giorgio Armani C. Now this one is actually a hair mist. I like the hair mist for this one because to me it stays on longer. I had a sample of the actual perfume in the scent and I find it that it didn't last long on me. So I decided to get the hair mist and this one stays on longer. I use this a lot in the summer, spraying it in my hair. It smells so good. Florally, but still clean, and it's just, I love the scent of this. We have here the Flower Bomb from Victor Rolf. Look how beautiful this packaging is. I believe I did a haul on this one, so I'll link that for you guys down below. I'm pretty sure I kind of like described like the notes and things like that in that haul, which I honestly don't remember anymore. So I'll just link it for you down below. It'll be very helpful. But yeah, I love the packaging of this one. Now, I haven't used this one that much because it is pretty strong, not gonna lie. Sometimes it gives me headaches. But yeah, it still smells really, really good, so I have kept it. Next, we have the Marc Jacobs Decadence. Now, this one is actually new to my collection. But can we talk about the packaging? It is stunning. It's like a cute little bag. Like, I just love it. So I actually smelled the first one, like the original version of this, a few years back, and it was just too strong for me. So when they came out with this one, I had to try it out. It smells so good. It's florally, of course. You can kind of probably see a pattern through my collection here. I like florally scents that's not too strong. So this one is just perfect for me. I absolutely love it. I highly recommend. I did a Instagram post on this, so if you want to see that, I'll put it over there so you can check it out. Okay, I have a few Chloe perfumes here. So we have this one, which I believe is Rose. And then we have Love Story. And then we also have the original Chloe perfume. This one right here is probably one of my favorite perfumes. It is perfect for like spring and summer. It just smells so nice and fresh and girly. I love it so much. And then if I want more of that florally scent, I go for this one. This is, I believe, the roses one. So you can really, you know, you really smell like roses with this. And this is Love Story. To me, this one smells, it's like in between these two. So I really do like this one as well. The packaging is stunning, you guys. And you actually pull this thing down and then you take the cap off. Isn't that neat? So I love the packaging of this one. I think it's so cute. One thing I don't like about these perfumes right here, this is silver and it actually oxidizes. So you always have to kind of polish it from time to time. It's kind of annoying because, you know, it's pretty when it's shiny, but when it starts to like oxidize, it's not as pretty anymore. So that's kind of a bummer with those, but I do love them. They smell really good. This is the Ariana Grande perfume. I think this is the first one. She has a new one right now, which I did not buy because it's too sweet. Like, this one is super freaking sweet already, you guys. Like, I like it, but it's just too dang sweet for me. So I like used it in the summer when I got it, and after that I'm like, nah, it's too sweet. But I have kept it because I do love Ariana Grande, and this is, you know, I don't know, it's pretty. Also, I purchased this on my birthday, I think, like, I don't know, whenever it came out a few years ago. So yeah, it's kind of sentimental as well. But yeah, I can't because it's just too sweet. Okay, so I have a few Marc Jacobs perfume. We have here Daisy, I have Daydream, and also I have Oh So Fresh. So I freaking love these perfumes from Marc Jacobs. Now, this Daisy perfume is probably the strongest out of the three that I have, but I love this one because it is sentimental for me. I actually purchased this on the very first cruise that I've been on. And I remember I paid, how much did I pay for this? I don't know how much this was. I don't even know the size of it. Oh, it's 3.4 fluid ounce. I believe I paid $60 for this on a cruise ship because it was on sale or something, and I'm like, yes. But yeah, so this is very sentimental for me. I will forever remember that first cruise that I've been on, and I just love it. But anyways, this and this I got last spring, and this one's probably my favorite out of the two. I used this one a lot last spring and summer. It's so good. It's like florally and girly at the same time, but it's not too overwhelming. This one, I don't know, I haven't really used it as much yet, so I kind of forgot already what it smells like, but it is one of those perfumes that's like florally and girly and clean. So yeah, they're kind of all the same, but this is probably my most favorite one out of the three. Next, I have some Lancôme perfumes. I have this one and this one, and they're both the La Bia Belle perfumes. Now, this is the new one that they came out with. It's actually really sweet. To me, at least, it smells very sweet. This is the original La Bia Belle. I freaking love this. I actually had a bunch of samples of this one, and I went through that. So this is like an actual bottle. It's only one fluid ounce though. But I love it. This one smells so good. It's definitely right up my alley. But yeah, I got this one recently and it's a lot sweeter than the original. So I'm not sure if I love this one, but definitely check out the original. It's nice, florally, girly, and also like sophisticated. So I love that scent. I have here the Givenchy Angelique perfume. Look how beautiful this packaging is. It's stunning. This is probably one of the strongest perfume I own. How I would describe this perfume is that it is fall in a bottle. So that's all you have to know. But it smells really good. I wore this a lot during fall time, like a few months ago. It smells really, really good. So Yeah. I have here Saint Laurent, the Black Opium. This smells so good, you guys. And like the packaging is stunning. So this is one of their new packaging for it, I think. I think they do this like every year. So why is it not focusing? But like, how gorgeous is that packaging? Now, I haven't used this as much as I would like to. It's one of those perfumes that sometimes gives me a headache, but it smells so freaking good. So I kept it in my collection. So this one is actually, to me, it's like musky and sweet at the same time. It smells really good though, but I don't use it enough because of that musky sweet scent. Sometimes it can get too overwhelming for me, but I do like it. It smells very good. Next, I have here the Tom Ford White Patchouli perfume. I probably use this like for a week, and then after that, it's just too much. I do like it. The patchouli is definitely strong in this one. It's super strong. It kind of does get really overwhelming from time to time when you wear it. Yeah, I mean, if you like that scent, the patchouli scent, and if you like something very strong and stuff, then you should check this out. But to me, it's just not something I would definitely grab like all the time. So yeah, but I keep it because it's beautiful. Let's see. Oh, I have here the Ariana Grande Hair Mist. Same scent as the perfume. So yeah, really sweet. Barely used it, but I bought it. So there it is. Okay, I have here Paris et Moi. By P. Couture or Jafra. I'll link it below. But I got this actually in a glossy box and it smells so freaking good. So this is actually a very sweet perfume. It actually kind of reminds me of a candy. But it's sweet and it smells good at the same time, if that makes sense. Like, I can actually wear this and not get pukey feeling because it's too sweet, you know what I mean? So I freaking love this perfume. I have here a lotion. This is Valentina by Valentino, and here's the perfume. I purchased this as a set when I went to California for the very first time with my friends. I was so excited, but yeah, we'll forever remember that trip. We went to see Backstreet Boys and just had so much fun. That was like my first Ipsy event. But anyways, I actually wore this perfume on my wedding day, so I will always remember my wedding day whenever I wear this as well. It's a very sentimental perfume for me. I try not to use it as much because I don't know, I just want to keep it for forever. But it is one of my favorite scents in the entire world. It smells so good. Again, it's like florally, a little bit powdery actually, but still clean and a little seductive too. So I just love how this smells. This is the lotion right here. I use it from time to time, but it has some shimmer in it, which I'm not a big fan of shimmery lotions. So yeah, but it smells just as good as the perfume. Next, I have the Nicki Minaj perfume. My mom actually purchased this for me for Christmas a few years ago. I wanted it so freaking badly. I got it, I love it, it smells good. I don't even remember what it smells like, to be honest, but I guess no, it smells good. Okay. Next, I have the Vera Wang Princess perfume. This is my very first perfume purchase ever. I purchased this, I think, end of high school or something like that. I don't know, a long time ago, and I love it. I've kept it, as you can see. I try not to use it because I want to keep it as a sentimental thing. I remember it smelling really good and I love it. It's like one of my favorites. I don't know what it smells like anymore, but I'm guessing florally and pretty and girly because, you know, it's a princess perfume. But yeah, so this is my very first perfume ever, you guys. Okay, last but not the least is this guy from Versace. This is the Bright Crystal perfume. Look at that. Look at the top of it. It's huge. So this is one of the freshest, cleanest perfumes ever. It is very bright, very fun, and yeah, just clean and fresh. That's just the only thing to describe it. So that's that one. That is that. I do have like minis in this cup right here that I do use from time to time. Like, I have Libia Belle. I have here Airy Shimmer perfume that I do like, but I don't really grab it that much. Here's the My Burberry blush again. Here I have the Viva La Juicy perfume. We have here the Erin Mediterranean Honeysuckle Kate Spade Walk on Air. And I think that's it. So those are my little like travel sizes. I don't remember where this cup is from, but I think it's from Papyrus. I could be so wrong though, but isn't it like the cutest thing ever? I love it. Okay, so I do have two more perfumes here on my vanity, as you can see. This one right here is Miss Dior Blooming Bouquet. It is one of my favorite perfumes, hence why it's on my vanity. As just like the name, Blooming, it is a very florally scent, but very fresh and clean and a little bit girly, so I really like it. And like, come on, the packaging is stunning. And of course, I have my Jo Malone Peony and Blush Suede Perfume on my vanity. Look at that, it's almost gone. Kind of makes me sad and happy at the same time. So that is it, you guys. That is everything. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you so very much for watching. Please don't forget to thumbs up this video. It really helps out my channel. Subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see y'all soon in my next video. Bye!